member to make comments on the or observations in relation to the report for a maximum of 20 minutes. If you did not have the opportunity to go, because the minute you see your order paper, we expect you to go to the documentation room and get a copy for yourself, unless you don't have interest in the report. But if you have interest, it's always there. So my assumption is that any member who went and picked is aware of what they want to say. And Kinyua, please, 2 minutes to finish your statement.
Thank you. Thank you, madam.
This is unprecedented. Madam Speaker,
I raised up my hand, and I'm sure maybe you not have heard me. On a point of order, when the chairperson was doing his presentation, Madam Speaker, because what I wanted to seek your guidance on is the chairperson of the committee in order to indeed mislead the House, because that's misleading the House in my view, when he challenges the contributions that were being made by members, while the report is here, Madam Speaker, and the recommendations made by the committee are clear. Madam Speaker, as day and light, and indeed in their recommendation number 2, they have clearly referred this matter back to the ministry, and they have relegated the same mandate that had been given to the committee to come up with a conclusion to the ministry to then recommend back to the committee the measures they are taking. And so in simpler terms, Madam Speaker, then what that means is the committee has simply abdicated the responsibility, Madam Speaker.
We got your point. Please don't go beyond the point of order.
So, Madam Speaker, my point is very simple, that I think the chairperson of the committee is indeed out of order to mislead the committee. The report is absolutely what the members have said, Madam Speaker.
Yeah, I've heard you, Senator Kinyua.
Thank you.
1 minute now,
Madam Speaker.
Is running out.
Thank you. I have looked at this report, Madam Speaker, and it's true. Their observation is very right, but the conclusion is very wrong, Madam Speaker. The recommendations are wrong. It's like saying, Madam Speaker, that Senator John Kenyon has teeth and a cow has teeth. That observation is very true. But for you to conclude John Kenyua is a cow, that is wrong. And it's exactly what they have done. Madam Speaker, if you look at what they are recommending, they are saying that they should be taken, all their recommendation, they should be taken back to the ministry. So there was no need in the first place for this complainant to come, or this complainant to come to the Senate. Madam Speaker, if you look, for example, at somebody called Gashushwa David Morevi, this person, I have interacted with him, and he's a graduate with bachelor's degree from Egerton University. And from what they investigated, they said this person did not exist anywhere, Madam Speaker. So what I want to say, and with a lot of respect for the chairman, who is the chairman of the committee, and he has been sitting in many committees, and he's been doing a good job. But on this one, Madam Speaker, I am feeling that they need to bring this report back to this House so that it can be investigated again. Look at what they are saying. They are giving the ministry 3 months so that they can go back and check the milestone in terms of implementing what they have recommended. Madam Speaker, it is this House that is supposed to make sure that many of these recommendations are implemented. Madam Speaker, they're even saying that we don't have the capacity as Senate to micromanage the institution. Madam Speaker, we are not micromanaging that institution. All what we are doing our oversight duties. So I am concerned why but Madam Speaker, I agree. That's why many of the senators who are sitting in that committee are disagreeing with this report. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Senator. Senator Mutula, 2 minutes. And please, I'm not taking new members on this one. I only have Senator Wambua and Senator Musurube, 2 minutes each.
Thank you. Madam Speaker, we will not mince words. This report is terrible. This is a terrible report. The committee, and Senator Kinyua has mentioned, says the ender must not be micromanaged. The minute you made that conclusion, you compromised yourselves. Completely compromised yourselves. Because we are an entity, and an entity that does oversight to public institutions. Madam Speaker, would you be surprised that the Treasury allocated this entity 406 million shillings this financial year? We are aware. Now, the 56 people who have been fired last year in 2020 were fired during COVID. During COVID. If you look at the list of people who have been fired, presupposes that there's somebody in that institution who is keen on hiring people of their own kin.
Yes.
It's not for nothing that they have fired people from all over the country. They have replaced them with people of their tribe.
Yes.
Lastly, if this committee was serious, because, and the judge is here, for the 56 cases, they would have a recommendation on what they found on the 56 people, because every dismissal is a cause of action.
Yes.
Aye.
Point of information from Senator Dullo. Dullo, please be very brief, because the minutes are, finished my
for your
minutes.
Information, Senator Mutula, the 56, after I brought the matter to the House, they reinstated 42 and left out the rest on the basis that they are not qualified. And one of them is the one mentioned by Senator Kinyua, who is a graduate and is not qualified. And the reason is because he is not a relative or a tribe of the CEO. That is why he was not returned.
Senator Dullo, be careful not to make the conclusions. We're expecting the chair to give us the conclusions, because those are the people who investigated.
In fact, this is the position.
Chair. I have a minute remaining.
It's 1 minute, actually.
Yeah.
I'm checking.
Yeah.
If there were 56 and 42 are reinstated, there should be a table showing they were reinstated. So that in the table on reinstatement, we check what discretion they used. So that we check whether the eight, there was an injustice or discrimination. Madam Speaker, this committee, my view, they should stand down on this matter. Stand down, just stand down. Stand down and allocate another committee. We, the Legal Affairs Committee, are prepared to handle this matter.
Thank you, Senator.
We're ready. Thank you.
Finish your minute, Senator Wambua, so I can come to the chair.
Very interesting. Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I will address myself to only two issues. One, observation number 16. Madam Speaker, that observation in itself tries to cast aspersions on the work of a Senate committee or the Senate in total. Madam Speaker, that observation is a very dangerous observation. Saying that ender should not be seen to be micromanaged by who and on what? Madam Speaker, issues must be raised. HR issues in all institutions, if they arise, they must be raised, and questions, answers should be provided to the issues raised. That does not amount to micromanaging. We're just inquiring into what's happening.
Thank you, Senator.
Secondly, Madam Speaker, I am of the view, very, very important view, that committee is saying that they will go back to site after 3 months. To do what? They have already made their recommendations, they have made their observations. Madam Speaker, that committee should stand down and give this job to the Legal Affairs Committee, Madam Speaker.
Senator, sorry, it was not Musurube, it was Senator Mohamud Mohammed who's has been flicking on and off. That is the last one, then I'll come back to the chair.
Madam Speaker.
No. It's too late, please. Yeah.
Madam Speaker, we didn't want to debate this report before, but Madam Speaker, I come from that region. ENDA is a Wasinya North Authority, which covers 100% my county and many other counties. Madam Speaker, after the inquiry which was made by the member, I've not read the report, but I know the story of the six people. The 56 were actually casual for many years, and they wanted to regularize. So they asked them to apply. They applied, and those who qualified were taken, that's what we're getting. And ENDA apparently covers all the counties. Madam Speaker, we want the report to be substantively moved so that, you know, we can debate it, so that, you know, because facts come out. Because the way it's coming now, the member has moved under 48.4, which is supposed to be comment for 20 minutes. We have now been talking for 1 hour. We have debated the report actually in a very procedural matter. Madam Speaker, I think to be fair to the to that report and to the authority itself, and also to the committee and the Senate, we need that report to be substantially moved and be tabled so that, you know, we can, because we are doing something which is very unprocedural now. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
I'm going to give the chair, and I want to guide the chair. Chair, you have listened to the sentiments. All the members. All the members. Senator Mohamud, you are. Senator Mohamud, please take your seat. I'm going to allow the chair to make comments that will help us resolve.
Thank you, Madam.
And I want him to tell to
Madam Speaker
to be sensitive to what the comments that have come from the members.
Yes.
And to tell us what else is required as a way forward.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank
Madam,
you.
Madam Speaker, thank you very much. Number one, as I said earlier, there is benefit in reading. You know when senators, for instance, the senators who've spoken, like Senator Mutula, standing and being so poetic about this committee should have done this, and he has not read the report. What he's asking for is in the report. The names of those eight people are in the report. But when you cast aspersions to a committee of this house, a competent committee, and Madam Chair, I know the work I've done in this house, it is unimpeachable over the last 3 years. Without having looked at the specifics in the report, it is unfair. Number one, Madam Speaker, there are 56 employees in this ENDA who for a long time, and the ministry together with ENDA, they acknowledge the fact that for a long time ENDA had had serious HR issues. In fact, the CEO and the board you're talking about has been a new board, Madam Speaker. That when they came in, they started the process of actually, you know, rationalizing that stuff. The 56 advertisements were not external. So when senator stands up and says somebody is firing people to hire their cronies, from where? The 56 were not external. Madam Speaker, of the 56, 50 applied for the advertised positions. One applied for an unadvertised position that is not there. Five did not apply. Madam Speaker, out of the 56, 42 are reinstated. Maybe the language used is wrong, but I don't see how you'd have wanted us to say you must hire this specific person as a senator. And they're absorbed. The names of those eight that senator is asking for, Senator Mutula, are in the report. The names of the eight. So, Madam Speaker, don't look at this, read the whole report. Madam Speaker, the names are in the report. Madam Speaker, additionally, we acknowledge that process of rationalization, including what department one is in, because, Madam Speaker, when you bring a statement and you have an outcome that you want, we cannot. That this person must be in a certain department. Madam Speaker, even if that comes to my committee, I will not do that. We cannot dictate that. But, Madam Speaker, what our work is to do, because I've dealt with numerous labor issues in all of your counties. Madam Speaker, what we must do, just allow me to finish, Madam. I don't want to get into an argument. I'm giving the way forward. Allow me to finish because it's a report that is
final. Okay, Senator Mutula.
Just give me time.
No, listen. Why don't you listen? You see, we as a Senate, our work is to pass recommendations. When you pass table a report, it's the recommendations that are actionable. We are simply saying there are no recommendations on that table. Yes. It's not that we don't know. So the point of it, but don't mislead the House.
Madam Speaker, that's debatable. And Senator Mutula is completely wrong. Listen.
Chair.
Madam Speaker, let me read out the recommendations properly. After having done that, we listened and we sympathize.
I did not want you to go there.
No, I must, because Madam Speaker, on the record of this House,
recommendations are being read out that are not our recommendations. And that is in the record of this House. Madam Speaker, listen. I beg the House to listen. We said that the Ministry and ORD, together with the management, must give us a report, comprehensive milestones on the status of the human capital reforms, and all the other, first of all, for what is under the purview. Number two, we said within 1 month, Madam Speaker, they must give us specific remedial measures taken to address the specific issues raised in the statement and the affected staff, the 8 of them. Number three, Madam Speaker, we have commissioned the National Gender Inequality Commission and Human Rights Commission to conduct an investigation on human rights violations. When somebody comes and says that my human right has been violated like this, someone says it has been done, someone says it has not been done, we cannot take aside. It is he say and she say. Madam Speaker, this Senate must be objective. Number three, we've said that once we've received those two reports as a committee, and I've gone to that county more than 3 times, once we receive that report as a committee, we shall go back to the site and we shall give further engagements and further recommendations. I don't see what else can be done, Madam Speaker. That is the position.
Thank you, Chair.
That is a report understanding Order 48. If there was a petition or a motion, it could have been dealt with in another manner.
Thank you, Chair.
Madam Speaker, and I stand on that position.
Thank you, Chair. Other members, it is true that understatements, normally we don't come and move a motion to debate a report. It's only the 20 minutes that give us the leeway. Fortunately, for the 20 minutes, some members read the report, others don't read the report. Those who read the report, in most cases when you don't have time, you read the observations and you read the conclusions. So most members have read the observations and the conclusions, and that's why they're wondering why there is no strong relationship as observed by different members. I do not think, as the member who asked the question, that there was a problem in the investigations. Because in her own words, she has said the committee did a commendable job, they have given very good observations, that the conclusions were short. I want to suggest this way. We are not looking for another committee. We are going to ask the same committee, because we have found that, we have said that there are members of the committee that do not meet, that there are members of the committee that some don't seem to be in agreement. Chair, I want to strongly recommend that you sit with your committee, look at your observations. If there is any gap that you need to fill, you fill it, and then reintroduce the report back. Thank you, and thus it has been ordered. Thank you. Thank you, I have finished. Next order. Honorable members, the next paper is paper number 5. Order, members. Please take your seats, members. I would like to inform the members, both online and the members in the House, that we are going to go into voting very shortly. And because we are going to go to voting, please do not move. Order, Senator Langat. Senator Mohamud and Senator Jeriat. Please take your seats. Then it's over. We are not going back. The report, we are expecting that report in only 14 days. Because, 14 days.
You have ruled. That's the end.
I have ruled and we are not revisiting that. If you need guidance, you will approach us differently. But we are okay. So that far we have ordered. Yeah.
Senator Mutula, paper number one, report on the standing committee. Is it on the same one? Why is there something else coming in between?
Madam Chair, Madam Speaker, this house is a house of rules, and the standing order is very clear on what language is used in this house.
Yes.
Madam Speaker, when you were standing, Senator Cheruiyot was standing. And in the process, Senator Langat, Madam Speaker, shouted and said, "Senator Cheruiyot, sit down, respect your poker." What is poker, Madam Speaker? And how can Madam Speaker be called poker in the Senate, Madam Speaker?
I think that was Griga, none of us understood. Senator Langat.
Given, give me. Okay, thank you, Madam Speaker. Just wanted to inform Senator Murkomen not to be collecting fatigue talks that goes around the corridors and bringing into the house, because they are not in record. So
okay,
I just wanted
you
to say it wasn't referring to you, neither anybody, was just talking about our own things here. So I'm sorry, Murkomen.
Thank you, Senator Mutula. Paper number one, report on the Standing Committee on Finance and Budget on the Prompt Payment Bill, Senate Bills number 16 of 2021.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'm sure we'll find out what that means in a few minutes. Madam Speaker, I beg to lay the following paper on the table of the Senate. Report on the Standing Committee on Finance and Budget on the Prompt Payment Bill, Senate Bill number 16 of 2021. Thank you.
Thank you. The last one is paper number five, report on the Standing Committee on Health on the special audit report of the utilization of the COVID-19 funds by the county governments. Chairperson, Standing Committee on Health. Vice Chair of Health.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I beg to lay the following paper on the table of the Senate today, the 29th of July, 2021. Report of the Standing Committee on Health on the Special Audit Report on Utilization of COVID Funds by the County Governments. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you very much. May I use my discretion to allow for the statement under 52.1, then we go to 48.1.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I raise pursuant to Standing Order 52.1. I hereby do present to the Senate the business of the House for the week commencing Tuesday, 3rd August 2021. Madam Speaker, on Tuesday, 3rd July 2021, the Senate Business Committee will meet to consider and approve business of the week. On that day, the Senate will consider bills at the second reading stage, motions on reports of various standing committees as contained in the program of Senate business. The Senate will also continue with consideration of bills, motions, petitions, and statements that will not be concluded in today's order paper. On Wednesday, the 4th August 2021, the Senate will continue with business that will not be concluded on Tuesday, 3rd August 2021, and any other business scheduled by the Senate Business Committee. On Thursday, the 5th August 2021, the Senate will continue with business that will not be concluded on Wednesday, the 4th of August 2021, and any other business. Madam Speaker, as the House is aware, the Senate has been in the process of republishing bills in line with the judgment of the High Court in Constitutional Petition number 284 of 2019. As of now, a total of 61 bills have been published. Out of the 61 bills, 21 are undergoing concurrence pursuant to Article 110(3). 29 are at the second reading, and 8 bills are at the committee of the whole stage. Madam Speaker, honorable senators, as indicated in today's order paper, there are 7 bills scheduled for division at the second reading stage at orders number 8 to 14. Further, there are 6 bills scheduled for committee of the whole stage. I take this opportunity to urge senators to avail themselves this afternoon for the division, and also urge the responsible senators and respective standing committees, chairpersons, to be available for the committee of the whole to allow for smooth transition to the next stage. Madam Speaker, I take this opportunity to applaud committees for their effort in processing filed statements and petitions referred to them. However, there is still a number of petitions pending conclusion in the Senate. I urge respective Senate standing committees to expedite consideration of the petitions and any other pending business and table reports pursuant to the standing orders. Madam Speaker, I thank you and hereby lay the statement on the table of the Senate.
Honorable senators, we are going to move to, we'll skip the statements for now and go for the next order because of the divisions that we, for the convenience of the House. So, next order. Okay, so order number 7, we have stood down and we are going to, can we now read, can the clerk please read orders numbers 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14.
Order number 8, the County Vocational Education and Training Bill, Senate Bills number 6 of 2021, second reading, division. Order number 9, the Basic Education Amendment Bill, Senate Bills number 4 of 2021, second reading, division. Order number 10, the Street Vendors Protection of Livelihood Bill, Senate Bills number 7 of 2021, second reading, division. Order number 11, the Startup Bill, Senate Bills number 1 of 2021, second reading, division. Order number 12, the Office of the County Printer Bill, Senate Bills number 13 of 2021, second reading, division. Order number 13, the Salaries and Remuneration Commission Amendment Bill, Senate Bills number 31 of 2020, second reading, division. Order number 14, the County Licensing Uniform Procedures Bill, Senate Bills number 32 of 2020, second reading, division.
Thank you. Can the division bill3 minutes only.
Six. Yes, all at once. Yes.
Seven.
Can we have tellers, please? Honorable senators, please take your seats. Other members, take your seats. Honorable members, if you are outside, come in. We'll give you another 2 minutes bell, 2 minutes of the bell. And our colleagues who are online, please be patient with us. We are going to be very fast.